What are the eligibility criteria and why are they necessary for a clinical trial?
So the eligibility criteria for clinical trials is a very important aspect of the clinical trial process. When we're looking at clinical trials, we want to study a specific population. So eligibility criteria will fit that. Now, examples of eligibility criteria could be a number of lines of prior therapy, prior exposure to drugs, say like daratumumab or carfilzomib. Other eligibility criteria include lack of concurrent disease, such as another cancer or things like that. Their eligibility criteria are used to basically screen patients to make sure that they can get on a clinical trial.
To go on to a clinical trial, you have to have certain characteristics. If you're looking at first-line myeloma, an eligibility criteria will be you cannot have been treated for myeloma before, because that won't be first treatment myeloma. So you're trying to narrow your population to answer a question. You also want to make sure it's safe. So for example, an eligibility criteria, you may have kidney or liver failure because that may not be safe for the drug. So common eligibility criteria, you have to have appropriate kidney and liver function. So there's usually a very long list of eligibility criteria to make sure the proper population is being enrolled upon a clinical trial.
Thanks for watching. By creating a HealthTree account, you can get exclusive access to the latest HealthTree University content, track your course progress, take quizzes, and bookmark lessons. Visit the links in the description below to get started.